Momentous May is how I'm going to define May 2020, as life is starting to pick back up for me after experiencing a devastating house flipping investment decision gone wrong. I sold my second house flip on May 15th to pay off 4 max credit cards and a student loan. Before the closing, believe it or not, I had 30 cents in my account. I haven't made any videos on this situation, but I lost somewhere around $70,000 after paying off my contractor's final quote. But we're only looking ahead, never behind us. A couple big things for me though this month. I was a guest on the Bigger Pockets podcast just a couple days ago, which is huge for any real estate investor. I'm really excited for all the people reaching out to me wanting to connect after listening to the episode. I've had a few people from Cincinnati reach out and want to partner up, and it is very humbling that people reach out and really enjoyed the episode. And I also found a couple partners up in Cincinnati. These are connections that I already had. And so my next real estate deals will be making money, not losing money. Also this month, Alex Becker made a response video to the Authentic or Charlatan episode I made of him. This was huge for me personally, but I think it might be even bigger for the make money online industry. I feel like there's some momentum right now that is being created by CoffeeZilla, Tom Nash, and myself, and there's also a myriad of others who are starting to really expose unethical business and marketing practices by these gurus. And most importantly, awareness for these practices is beginning to enter the market, which is really exciting for me because that's been my whole goal with the Authentic or Charlatan series. This is huge for us as we continue the fight against the industry that is rife with fraud. What an outstanding intro. Let's deep dive into the numbers for May. I'm going to start with the YouTube analytics. I think you guys are more interested in these numbers than the actual spreadsheet, but we'll get to that in a minute. So I'm looking at the last 28 days. Let's change this to last 90 days just to see where the channel's going. This is views. 1.1 million views. This blows my mind. It took me something like 63 months to hit my first million in views, and it's only going to take about 70 days to hit my second million. So thank you very much for those who are tuning in. This is pretty wild to see. So since this video is discussing May, let's switch over to May. May was a great month, 856,000 views, and you can see it's still trending upward from beginning to the end of May, getting to over 50,000 views for two days. I had over 50,000 views. That's incredible. I definitely think the Becker video gave me a boost. Bigger Pockets gave me a boost, but this is just a trend we're seeing. This channel is growing and growing and growing. I mean, we're seeing 3x growth by the end of the month, and that continues. It's very humbling to see so many people care about the channel. So we'll go to subscribers. Let's go to last 90 days for subscribers. Again, the same trend. I was averaging somewhere around 30 subscribers a day back in March. I got furloughed right here at April 17th. And then you can see the trend upward. And I had a 620 subscribers for the day of Thursday, May 28th. That is wild. Last 90 days, almost 15,000 subs. So let's go to May. 11,600 subscribers. Last video, I was hoping to surpass 20,000, and we've surpassed 24,000. I couldn't be more happy. This is crazy growth, and it looks to be a trend. And what I've noticed with YouTube is that when you go back to last 90, there seems to be a lot of little trends that you have as you grow. Here's the last 365 days. You can see that you have little bumps, and you steadily grow and grow and grow just a little bit, and then you see little bits of growth here and there. Maybe that's just my channel. It seems to be the case though, when you watch some of the people that have grown a lot, they seem to have like up, plateau, and it's pretty cool to see. So anyway, so now let's go to the most important part, the revenue. Revenue for May, $7,636. That is crazy. The previous day, $364 on Sunday, May 31st. That blows my mind. $364 a day. This is something like $120,000 over a full year if I average that for the full year. But just like all the other metrics, if you see the chart, you're seeing an average of $20 to $30 a day back in March, and then it's upticking up to $300. I mean, this is a 10x growth, over a 10x growth in just 3 full months. So if we continue seeing the same growth on this channel in 3 to 6 months from now, I mean, we're starting to see Graham Stephan numbers, which that'd be pretty remarkable. I don't know if that'll be the case. And if any of you guys care, I don't know if you guys care about these types of numbers. I think they're pretty interesting. 15 million impressions. This is, I mean, my videos were put in front of 15 million eyeballs. That's pretty crazy. 4.8% click-through rate. I don't know what the average is. I've heard it's between 2 and 4%. The benefit of this going lower is that that typically means that your impressions are going up. As more people see your videos, less people are going to click just by the law of averages. Oh, sorry, this is the last 90 days. But May, we saw 11.9 million impressions, 4.8%, which looks to be a little down. But that's okay because I'm getting in front of a lot more eyeballs. It's more subscribers, more views. All the good metrics are going up. So I don't really care about the CTR rate right now. Let's check out engagement. I don't know if you guys care about these numbers. at all. Revenue, we've already gone over revenue. The estimated monetized kickbacks is, or excuse me, estimated monetized playbacks is a number that I really do care about. And so I've been analyzing how many, or you know, what the percentage is. So if I have 676,700 monetized views against 856,500, 856, I'm sorry, I'm using my calculator right now. That's 79%. That's a little bit of an uptick. I can't remember what it was last month exactly. It was something like 76%, but that is an uptick of probably 2 or 3%. That means, you know, for me, I don't know if you guys are big data guys, but for me, when I analyze that, that means that I'm getting, for every viewer, every new view, I'm making just slightly more, which when you start talking about bigger numbers, it starts to matter a lot. So I couldn't be more thankful for the YouTube growth. This is incredible. Thank you everyone to who has been following along and watching all the videos. So let's get into the fun stuff. So I have a chart and something I'd highly recommend. I use a chart for my basically my personal business, and then I also do one with my house. And so this is a chart for my house. And these numbers probably look pretty crazy for some of you that don't know about house hacking. And what I essentially do is I have a 7-bed, 5-bath house here in Las Vegas, which is crazy for some people, but I bring in a lot of income, almost 16,000 so far in just 5 months, and one renter is paid in June. So that's a high income, and I'm cash flowing throughout the year. That's with me living in the property. So this is certainly not for everyone. If you guys are interested, please reach out. I'm probably gonna make a course on this one day whenever I become like a true expert in this. But this is essentially the best way for any beginner. If you're trying to increase your income, you live here somewhere in the United States and you can get in a house where you can start renting out the rooms to roommates, and you do so in a way that, you know, offers them a lot of value and they pay you a fair rate for the room, then you can really boost your income. And that's what's helped with me so far this year. I had a big expense this month for at my house, so I keep charts. And the reason why I'm showing you this is I think everyone should be keeping these kind of charts for themselves. It's a great way to analyze your income and expenses. So I added solar attic fan. If you guys are in a desert like Las Vegas or anywhere with the sun where it beats down on your house and your roof, I would highly recommend one of these. It was $565, but it has drastically helped the house. It has drastically helped the heat stay out of the attic. So it basically pulls all the heat out of the attic, and it's allowed me to put the AC on a 3 to 4 degrees, sometimes upwards of 5 degrees warmer, which helps with your electric and your AC, the long-term wear and tear of your AC unit. This will help tremendously. This is something I'd highly recommend. This is an investment to me, not so much an expense. But anyway, I had some other expenses, $830, but I'm still cash flowing. Even in May, still cash flowing $1,000. It's a lot of money. And so I'll show you kind of the details. So here's the personal finance. I unfortunately didn't have any income from my W-2 job in May as I've been furloughed. I do get unemployment. And for those of you, some of you might mention that you see I make a lot of money outside of the unemployment number. I know a common criticism is to look at that and say I shouldn't be receiving money because I receive money elsewhere. However, my job was my stability. And as I'm about to show you, I lost a lot of money recently. My job was acting as, that was my stability to pay all my bills. And YouTube's starting to take off. But this was, I have a lot of expenses, and as I'm about to show, I'm still losing a lot of money this year. So please don't look at this as like I'm some greedy dude. I'm still in the hole big time. Like this month I lost basically 15 grand. I'm definitely going to be meeting with my CPA to figure out the logistics of all this. But anyway, let's move on. So I had $100. Funny enough, I made $100 helping someone write an article for their blog post. But here's YouTube income for the month. We already discussed this, 7,600. I received most of rent. This guy in the garage unit, as you can see, he's been struggling to pay rent. I cannot evict in this moment, which really sucks because he owes me about $1,400 now, and I really could use the money. But he's struggling, and I'm not struggling as much, so I can't complain too much. You know, it'd be nice if he can pay up, but you know, I care about more about his sanity and more about him getting back on his feet than paying me back. So he'll be paying that back slowly. But I was able to receive most of the rent, and you see this number right here. This was one of my houses that I sold up in Cincinnati. 30 grand loss that was realized this month because it sold. Here's another property that I had. I lost 25 grand. So between them, I lost a lot of money. And I gave you these two numbers. I lost about 15 grand this month, but really the real number that I brought in was almost 15, because this number has been, I've been losing money for a long time. It was very, very rewarding to finally get out of two loans. If any of you guys are real estate investors or you flip houses, you understand there's a lot of costs that go into holding loans whenever you're flipping the house. You know, you might see some of these TV shows that look all sexy and how much money they make, but you know, they don't talk about all the, you know, utilities, the energy bill, your loan. I mean, it was costing me like $4,000 a month just to hold it. So to get out of those was really beneficial. Another development for this month that was nice is we were able to push off the mortgage 2 months. So in July, we're gonna have to pay in full for 3 months, but it was nice to kind of push some of those expenses off so I can kind of get out of debt. As you see, my expenses this month were almost $10,000, which is huge. And down here, I keep track of just kind of the yearly numbers. So I've been making a little money, but I have so many expenses. And the reason why this number looks weird is just because of all the loss. So far this year, I've lost a little over $42,000. And that's an awesome number, isn't it? Don't you just love the idea of losing $40,000? It really sucks, let me tell you. It is not fun. I'll certainly bounce back, but it's been a rough 18 months. I'll make videos on this because, of course, I will. It's about it's important that I make videos about losing money because I'll be making plenty about making money. But yeah, this is a tough number to stomach because I was trending upward. It seemed like my life was really starting to take off, and I took on some bad real estate deals. Well, they were really good deals, but it just went bad. But anyway, I'll talk about those deals later. But yeah, I have a lot of expenses that are finally gone. And hopefully I'll be getting back to work here soon, July or August. That'd be really helpful for me mentally and just to get back to work. But I'm very thankful for all the income that's starting to bring in. I mean, making $15,000 this month, I used to dream about making that much amount of money. And here I am. And a lot of it's the YouTube. The YouTube seems to be taking off. And so we'll be looking at even bigger numbers in June. And so back to YouTube, what my goal is, since I did this last month, I really want to hit 40,000 subscribers by the end of June. So on July 1st, I want to see 40,000 here. The revenue for the month, 7,600. It would be really great to get to 12,000. If I can get to 12,000 next month, that would be super dope. And then I think the last number is just views overall. It'd be really cool to get a little over 1 million views for the month, the entire month. We're at 856. I think we can boost that 20% just with the growth of the channel. Shoot, we may even be able to double it. If we can get 1,000,005 next month, I think that would be a good target to hit. So 1.5 million views for the month of June. A boost of about 16,000 subscribers to get to 40,000, and then revenue, it'd be nice to see a boost to about 11 or 12,000. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you guys enjoy this videos. Please leave a comment if you guys are going to guide these videos. I make them because I enjoy it. If you're getting any value out of it, that's great. That's the point of this. But I think these videos will be really fun to track as we go throughout the months, just to see kind of the growth. Anyway, thanks for watching.